So you can actually go here, see, you can just move around while Coop's just stands there. Once you release X, he's gonna hit back. So what you want to do is actually keep Coop there and go to the other side. Now release Coop's and hit this as well with your hammer. And voila, we've opened the path. There's nothing over the other side, right? So I'm just curious. I don't think there's any. Yeah, there's nothing. So let's head to Cocktail's castle. Now this part of this is like the first dungeon of the game. Not every chapter has a dungeon, but some of them do. Anyways, this is actually pretty fun dungeon, I guess. It's actually pretty creative. So let's head out here and you can see Cocktail's castle. Or Cocktail castle. I really like how they show it off to you once you come here. Oh man, Cocktail castle. That stories were all true. This place is terrifying. Not really. So let's head down here and get another badge or a star piece or a Cocktail badge. Yep, HP plus. You can use this to increase your HP by 5, but it costs 3 BP. And like I said, I'm not gonna use it since I'm doing a 10 HP run. So let's head up here and you can heal if you want. But if you come here, there's actually a paper airplane which will help us cross the gap or the broken. Yeah, the gap. Since the bridge is broken. So now let's enter Hooktail's castle. Oh, I've got a new enemy. Is there anything up here? No, there's nothing. Just a way back. She attacked first. Okay, these are the same as the Koopas, but they're Fire Koopas. They have 2 HP, 8 HP, 4 attack is 2, defense is 1. Okay, good. Now let's see what Coop's has, since we never used it. Now Coop has 10 HP, defense is 1, just like the actual Coop has. Now he has Shell Toss and Power Shell. Power Shell actually attacks all the enemies. Oh, I failed. Attacks all the enemies, which is actually pretty useful. His regular attack just attacks one enemy, it's the same thing, but it only attacks one enemy. So we've got 90 star points, we need 11 more and we can level up. Which one did I attack first? The Koopa or Koopa? This is Coop's normal attack. Okay, good, we've attacked the Paratroopa. Okay, that guy has an item. I think this item increases your defense. for us to get to the middle of this faster point. Also. Please get no. Oh, I really needed it. We're about to fight another mini boss. Oh, level up, yes! Thank God. Oh, that's before the mini boss as well, that's pretty good. So, now this time let's power up BP. Yeah. Actually, that's actually pretty good. Oh, we also get the item. This crystal gives you the partner's defense and boost. Okay, let's put Happy Heart on last time. I think we get another. Oh! Okay, this item is actually pretty broken, this badge. I'm not sure, I have to use it. I mean, I'm doing an 10 HP run, but not now. It's really useful against bosses or enemies with a high HP. So is this where we fight the mini boss? Yep, this is where we fight it. So let's compel to tattle him, or to tattle the new enemies. Okay, never mind, Coops is out. Oh no! These wounds, they remind me of my father. There's no doubt about it, it's my father. Dad! Crying. What's this? Mario, my father is clutching some kind of letter, or at least it's a bones roar. So what should I do? Should I read it? Yeah, read it. It's your father. I mean, that, if that's what he's saying. Okay, I'll read it. I came to this castle to destroy Octo, but I am stuck and I cannot go further. So in this letter, I shall note Octo's weakness for those who follow. The dread Hooktails cannot tolerate creatures that begin with CR and ends with Cricket. So it's Cricket. Something hidden in this castle is an item related to Hooktails' weakness. If one is to have any hope on defeating Hooktails, one must first find that item. One last thing, if you're faced with ultimate doom, the fiend will use any trick to save itself. If you hope to defeat it, do not give in your kinder nature and fall for its tricks. Alas, I do not have the strength to continue writing. Already mist fills my eyes. My last words go to my son, Colorado. I love you, and I'm proud of who you've come. Oh my god, Claudio's actually from the first game, he's an archaeologist, and this is his father? That's actually pretty sad. My son Claudio, not Coops. Anyways, yeah, like I said, they give you hints about how to defeat Hooktail. Hooktail is actually pretty difficult without that item, but I'll try to beat him without it. It's very difficult. You clearly don't value your life as much if you've come to this castle to disturb us. You will go no farther, and from this moment on, you'll be nothing but bones. I think it should be you'll go no further, since it's a distance. What's with these numbskulls? Oh, watch it. Actually, they're shoveling me around. Mario, watch what we do. Attack. So yeah, let's fight. Now first let's start. We got dark bones and red bones. This is the main boss, you don't need to tattle him, but he has an HP of 5 and defense of 1. Attack is 2, I think this has HP of 3 defensive. Or HP 1 or HP 2, I'm not sure. Oh, match with HP 1 defense, 1 attack is 2. Okay. Yeah, let's switch partners. As you can see, Coop has 1 defense. Oh, he has attack is 3 actually. Okay, let's do power as well. And that's all that. He has 1 more skill left. But I want to show. Yeah, he can rebuild his, dull bones. So, if you want, you can actually get 99 XP from this battle. But I'm not gonna do so, it's gonna take forever. So let's just finish him off. We got 22 star points, yeah. That's it, it's really pretty easy. But remember, there's a key here, because it's gonna be important later on. That was really stupid. Oh yeah, these are shiny sprites. There are a lot of them in the game. For each 3 you collect, you can power up a partner at Merlis. So yeah, I need them to power up Cook. I did the Stylus as well. The Stylus that Cook succeeded. So yeah, let's head on forward. There's another key up here. Now this castle has a lot of creative puzzles, if you ask me. And let's do this. I'm breaking down. No. Yeah, let's do this, yeah. Because I think there's something hidden up there. Yep, there's a hidden door. I think with the star piece. Yep. Now I'm not sure if there's something up there. I think there is, but you can't reach it from this part or from this block. Maybe there is something right here, but I don't think you can reach it. Okay, let's hit the switch with Koops. I really like Koops, he's amazing. One of the things I really like about this game are the partners. They are way better than the ones from Paper Mario 1. Anyways, we've got the key, so let's open the door. Well, and let's edit it here first. If you go up, there's actually a locked door, so you can't do anything about that. Oh my god, Goombas. There are a pair of Goombas in this area. So yeah, we've beaten the Goomba and Paracopet. Oh my god, I have Bloodborne, sorry. So have you guys heard about how they're releasing Super Mario Maker on the 3DS and Yoshi's Woolly World? They're taking a lot of games from the Wii U and putting them on the 3DS, which is really weird. I mean, are they planning on continuing the Wii U on the 3DS? I mean, I'm not sure what they're doing exactly. But whatever, I think it's a good idea to continue the series. And honestly guys, I think that 3DS is the best system that Nintendo has made so far. It has amazing games and a lot of games you can buy from the shops, and it's just an amazing device overall. I love it. The Wii U was also great, but I don't know why it's not receiving a lot of love. One game that I'm really excited for is Breath of the Wild. I'm a huge Zelda fan, it's my favorite. I love Zelda games, and Breath of the Wild looks really amazing. Oh yeah, look, we've got another of these black chests, so we know the drill. We need the black key, so let's find it. Oh god, remember later on this game, this is really useful, so remember there's a crack here. And if we open this, we find the black key, but oh no, it's a booby trap. Mario, look at that. Yep, we have to escape the room before this squishes us. There's actually a timer, so really fast. I think it's really easy. It's pretty easy, yeah. And we're done. If you actually get squashed, it's a game over. So don't do that. Okay, now let's open the treasure chest. Now we're gonna get another ability. Yep, no long time to say you're gonna you want my help, you won't curse me, and then once I unlock you're gonna curse me. I'm sorry guys, I don't like to go through dialogues that are just there. Unless it has something to do with the story or something new, then I'm not gonna go through it. So basically he gives us a new ability, this one. This time you can actually press R and become Paper 10. Yes, it's a curse, I understand. I'm cursed, oh no, I'm upset. So yeah, we can now escape. And remember that they said we read that Hooktail has a weakness, well this is it. If we equip it, I think it requires 0, yeah, 0 PP. So if we equip it, see it develops a quicker sound. But I'll try to beat Hooktail without using it. Let's see how it goes. Before we head up there with the green block, we need to get the key that we saw earlier. Since we have the new ability to return Paper 10, we can actually get the key now. Where is it? Yep, it's here. So yeah, in the Breath of the Wild, they are introducing a lot of items like the fire rod, the ice rod. There is a video showing how it is used, but I haven't seen it. One item that actually looks really interesting is the magnet thing. There's a magnetic item that can be used to pull metals and open doors and stuff like that. It looks really awesome. And the game in general looks amazing. So yeah, like I said, we need a key to open this. But before we do that, there's a badge here, but we can't get it yet. Let's sit here and hit the switch. And now here we have to hit the switch with cubes. Now you can see the window's open, so you can actually jump out there. Because if you continue forward, there's no switch here and you can do anything. But if you fall, you can actually get yourself a star piece. Yep. Yeah, so yeah, you have to jump out of the window right here to go to the other side. I have a cousin who played this game and really liked the idea of this puzzle, or the idea of jumping through a window. I don't know why. I mean, I guess it's kind of a neat idea. I mean, you're used to hitting switches, but now you have to jump through a window. It's a weird idea, but it works. One thing I really don't like about RPGs is that you have to battle the system. It's fun at first, but at some it gets kind of boring and then fun at times, and it's boring at other times. Especially when you have to fight the same old enemies or same enemies over and over again, and they're pretty easy. Okay, here we needed cubes. Oh, what the hell, cubes? We failed. Alright, yeah, thank you. And there should be a Paragomb right here. Yeah? As you can see, the door is locked here, so let's go to the other side. And, oh, this is an enemy. Now if I enter this door, something will happen. A cutscene. Who's that? Huh? Oh my, who's this handsome piece of cheese? I can't believe there are other thieves who are here besides me. How very strange. Hey, who are you? Me? Why, I'm Miss Mouse, the globe-trotting thief. Heard of me, sweetie? I heard there were rare and valuable badges here in this castle, that's why I'm here. But the real question is, why are people like you roaming in such a rundown place? Well, you see, we're here to be talked on and get them with the crystal star. So don't think we'll let you get the crystal star first, no matter how cute you are. Crystal star, you say, I didn't know a thing like that was hidden in this castle. Sounds intriguing. Perhaps I just heard something you didn't want me to hear. Darn. Oh, but that's okay. I mean, you were looking for the crystal star first, and I already found the badge I was after. So I'll let you get the crystal star. Hey, what's this supposed to mean? Amari gets a kiss from another lady. First Kumbala and now this Miss Mouse. It means I must say bye-bye for now, Mr. Cutie. I know it's sad, but we'll just meet another time, yeah, bye-bye. Oh my, you're so bold. Is that legal? Oh, I almost forgot. I have a little secret to share with you. Somewhere in this castle is a badge that I hope you beat best Hooktail or ever heard. I don't know what kind of badge it is, maybe you found it already, or maybe not. If you're going to fight Hooktail, I recommend finding the badge first. Yeah, I already got the badge, thank you, sweetie. Remember, he gets kissed by all the ladies, it's just weird. So anyway, we get another star piece, shine spot here, so one more, we can power up a partner. Okay, here we get the castle key. Here we get a mushroom. And here we get... honey syrup, this restores 5 HP. I'm gonna throw them open, it's pretty pointless. Now if you fall here, I think you get something. Yeah, you get this life stream. Now here, if you die, you can actually come back to life by using this, but I'll try not to use it. I mean, I'll try only to use it to just recover HP, not to recover from death. Because, like I said, I'm doing a 10 HP run, and it'll be kind of cheap just to have 10 or 20 life streams just to get back, just to come back from life every time I die. I'm gonna skip this Goomba. So anyways, if we head here, there are supposed to be more doll bones, yeah. Yeah, guys, I want to say, when I first played this game, I never knew about Hooktail's weakness, so I had to beat Hooktail without using the badge, which was pretty difficult. I was really confused as how Hooktail was the first boss of the game. When it was really difficult. But then I realized there was a Hooktail badge. That's pretty nice. I mean, they made the first boss difficult, but if you want it to be easy, I have to use a badge. So yeah, well, let's just finish these enemies. I'm sorry guys, I know it might bother you guys that I'm not using the A to block the attacks, but I'm trying to counter them. I'm just trying to crack it, so later on in the game it becomes easier. So we've beaten, yay! We got some bones here, and then I think one of the wait. Yep. Now let's fight. I just want to get rid of this as possible. Oh my god! All right. I'm gonna jump on this guy so he can't use his. So he can't use his item. I'm gonna kill this guy so he doesn't use a mushroom. Yep, I can't. Let's lift this guy up here. Okay. There's one more army left. Let's finish off with the jump. I love this stylish man. It's pretty awesome. And we got 10 star points out of this. So just 20 more and we level up again. So when was you want to hit this and then use scopes to hit it again. And there should be a star piece around here. Yeah, there it is. Is there anything over here? I don't think there is. Yeah, there's nothing. So let's go through here. We have 11 so we have 12 surfaces so far. That's actually really good. First time I tried to do this, it was really difficult. I mean, I felt like the airplane was just too far away from the actual place we want to reach. From the door. So, let's try again. Okay, this time we did it perfect. I guess now we're at the end, but before we go up, let's grab a badge. Oh, let's grab a key. And then we jump down here and grab a badge. And now we have to climb all the way back up again. Which is something I really hate about this part. I'm sorry guys, something happened and I guess the recording cut a bit. Was cut. But we were right here, we got the badge. And now we're heading back down here. Jump out of the window. I'm gonna meet you guys where we were. As you guys can see, Luigi is cheering for us. Go, Luigi! Okay, I'll meet you guys where we were. Sorry guys, I've been commentating, but we're back. Anyways, if you come up here, we get another chance pack. So now we have three, so we can actually power up one of our partners. And if you open this door, we're in the final stretch. Oh, yep, we're outside now. Hooked us just up ahead, so be ready, guys. Oh my god, there are a lot of enemies here. I'm just... Okay, I'm just gonna use this. Yep, I countered it, yay! I mean, I really love countering damage attacks. Not only do you receive 0 damage, but you also deal 1 damage back, if they touch you, actually. shot me, man. He struck first. Oh, I see one of them has a badge. Yeah, enemies can also use badges or have badges. You can actually steal them from them, but with the right partner, one of the partners can steal item badges from them. Oh guys, we're almost to level up. Just before the boss as well, so that's pretty good. There should be one more enemy left, so yeah, we got this in the bag, or the level up, I mean. You can't jump out of these windows, so don't try. So yeah, after this we should level up. Oh, so this is gonna be really nice. Funk counter attacks, so bad. Please don't hit me, please. Got it, partners. Anyways, let's just finish this. And guys, I get another level up. Okay, now this time I'm gonna... level up, PG. Since I'm gonna get a lot of items soon, or badges, I guess. So yeah, guys, this is the end. So I really hope you enjoyed the first episode. And in the next episode, we're gonna be tackling Hooktail. So I really hope you enjoyed, guys, and stay tuned.